show.
Okay, welcome aboard, everybody. My name is Enrique Hernandez. If you guys have any questions along the way, let me know, and I will try to find you an answer. Right now, we're going to be heading down to the main strip. Our next stop is going to be Valley's Hotel and Casino. Remember to hold on to those tickets. On our right, we have the Echelon project, which was stalled right before the economy went down. The company decided to put a hold on it, and it was a pretty good decision because the week later is when the market went down and their stock went up 20%. This is where the Stardust used to be. The Stardust was portrayed in the movie Casino with Robert De Niro. Right in front of it on the empty lot, that's where the Frontier, the new Frontier, the next Frontier, all the Frontiers were located at. That was the longest streak of a casino. On your left, we have the Wynn and the Encore. They are both considered the best hotels in the world. They have 5-star ratings on every category. If you go inside, they have a Ferrari dealership that you can buy a Ferrari. If you want to check out the cars, you just pay a $10 entry fee to check them out. But if you already have a Ferrari, you can go in there for free. I think that's pretty funny because when you're wealthy enough to buy a Ferrari, you don't care about $10. Where the Wynn stands right now is where the Desert Inn used to be. The Desert Inn was the location where Howard Hughes came to stay when he moved here in 1967. After a year of his eccentricities, the management had enough of him, so they tried to kick him out, but Howard Hughes was never good at listening to other people, so he decided to buy the property himself and fired the whole management. When he found out he could get a pretty good deal on a casino, he decided to buy other properties without even having to leave his room. And he was the one that brought in the corporate age, that brought the huge projects of the new casinos, like the Mirage, Treasure Island, MGM. On your right, we have the fashion show mall, which they have a runway fashion shows. If you want to check out the latest brands, they do the performances every weekend, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. But if you want to get a good deal on the same exact brands, you can go down to the premium outlet mall. They have huge discounts ranging from 30 to 70% off. Right in front of us on the right, we have the Treasure Island. The Treasure Island was the one that sent the Desert Inn into its way when the Desert Inn was imploded. Main ship fired, cannon shot straight into the wind. I mean the Desert Inn that began its implosion. It was a very well choreographed move. The Palazzo and the Venetian on your right are one and the same. Combined together, they have more than 7,500 rooms. Inside the Venetian, you can go and shopping with your own personal gondola. It's only $65. But, for that type of experience, I think it's priceless. On the right, the Mirage. Steve Wynn's first big project. And if you notice, the windows are very true old color. The reason for that is because when Wynn wanted the Mirage We also have the forum shop. Here, this is one of the most successful shops in the United States. Inside you can find many, many brands and very good restaurants. Right next to them is the Caesars Coliseum that was built specially designed for certain performances. But also Rod Stewart, Jerry Springer performed there. Both the gentlemen, chair, quite a few others. On the left, we also have the Flamingo. That's Bugsy Siegel's biggest accomplishment, and it was also his downfall. The mob thought he was skimming money from them, but I think it was actually his girlfriend, though. There was double pricing everything he put into the casino. And he was shot in California for that suspicion, but after his death, the casino started to make more of a profit than they imagined. Right in front of us, our next stop, the Bally's, is going to be. It's where the MGM used to stand. The MGM went up in flames, but resurrected itself on the other main street at Tropicana as the MGM Grand. Bally's used to be a gaming company for making slot machines, but they realized that they could also make money using the slot machine themselves. Attached to the Bally's is also the Paris. You can go up to the observation deck on the Alpha Tower. The Alpha Tower is half the size of the original. And the original does not have the lake of the Bellagio right in front of it. It has a water fountain show going off every 30 minutes of the day and every 15 minutes at night. If you guys are excited to get up here, we will have a new tour bus every 20 minutes. We run from 10 to 6, so be aware of the times. Looks like we have a few more customers coming along for the ride. Pieces of music you can listen to: Andrea Bocelli, Garth Brooks, Frank Sinatra, many different artists, songs choreographed with the music. The Bellagio was used for the filming of Ocean's 11 and Ocean's 13. The reason why the Strip is so far away from downtown is the mob, when they were making their own casinos down here and downtown, they were getting more and more restrictions and taxes from the city. So they decided to build outside the city limits, which became the Strip. This street actually used to be a highway that if you kept going south, it'll take you down to San Diego. The first casino here on the Strip was El Rancho. El Rancho used to be where the fashion show was. planning on building your own casino, you got to team up with corporate companies. That's a good stuff right now, but back in the old days, many big families were connected to Las Vegas from Chicago to New York, but now they've all been, they were all sent off with a big check by Howard Hughes. When Hughes was signing those checks, the FBI was right behind the mob with the tax exposure. Filled with memorabilia. The menu is on the wall, so if you don't, if you show up a little early, wait for your friends. A big influence here in Las Vegas. We built many companies here. That's why we have this street called Howard Hughes Parkway. On this same street, on both sides, you have quite a few selection of restaurants. If you guys decide to go off the strip, this is the location. Our next stop is beauty contest with the girls' dresses made to look like an atomic bomb going off. When the explosions were going off, the casinos actually made appointments with their guests to take them down in front of the mountain so they can see the explosions go off. And some other casinos, they also have their guests sit on top of their own property so they can see the explosions go off while they're drinking their atomic cocktails. But that was the time before they realized no fear side effects. Our Rock Casino. law school. Our law school has many applications for enrollment as but we fixed it. And the other guitar was used in the film on there, which the airplane flies right next to it and breaks part of it. And if you see on the doors, it says when this house is rocking, don't bother knocking the door. That's because they hold quite a few concerts in there. I went to one with Stephen Adler. Flower has always been the traffic cone. That's because we're always building something new, and something new old is always going down. Right in front of us, we have a building with a billboard of Viva Elvis.
That is the world's most expensive billboard because the building was built to completion and then they realized that it was built incorrectly. So right now they have to figure out a way to bring it down without affecting the other computer projects around it. Tilting towers on the left are also one of the most unique buildings here in Las Vegas. The towers do not just tilt, but they also torque as they go up. Most of the spaces inside are for office use and business. Looks like we have quite a few newcomers. Coming up on your right is Italian style casino and hotel. Inside the Monte Carlo you can find a bar called the whole bar is made out of ice, even your glasses are made out of ice. But don't worry, they give you a coke and some bugs to pull that up. Monte Carlo, the Aria, and the Duraccio are connected with a tram that you can ride for free. Several properties have connecting trams because most of them are by the same company or they like to share a business. The Excalibur, the Luxor, and the Mandalay Bay also have a free tram connecting them. On your right, we have the New York, New York. The New York, New York is set to represent the New York in the 1960s, and this is a replica of the Brooklyn Bridge. The roller coaster around the New York, New York is set to flying over the city, but some New Yorkers tend to tell me that as scary as getting a New York cab for the city. I don't know if that's true. I haven't been to New York. There we have a new bus every 20 minutes. Inside the Luxor, they also have a unique restaurant that if you go inside, the waiters and waitresses treat you badly on purpose. Yes, people do pay for that. On the left, we also have the Luxor, one of the most unique casinos here on the strip. Pyrotechnics cover most of the casino around it. And they are both also connected with a bridge that crosses from one to another. That bridge is not just a simple bridge, they also have shopping around it, so while you cross from one to another, you can do some shopping. Okay, this is going to be our stop for the Excalibur. Just be aware that we run from 10 till 6, so be aware of the times, and if you think you might not make it to the next book, ask your driver for downtown, and you can explore downtown for an hour, see the Fremont Street Experience light show, and see many of the attractions down there. Once it brings you back, the tour is over, but you also get a live guide telling you everything about the strip that you need to know. Angle. And they're not called elevators. They're called inclinators. Inside the Luxor, they also have the show Believe by Chris Angel. You have the hotel on your right. You have Mandalay Bay, and there's another one. The third one is only the last four levels of the Mandalay Bay. It's called the Four Seasons. Inside the Mandalay Bay, research and stuff. You might not be able to find a ticket at the tickets for tonight, but if you go straight to the box, you should find a few of the tickets. Inside the Mandalay Bay, they also have an aquarium that you can go right through, but that's a tunnel going right through the aquarium. $5,000, but she decided to keep it in public domain so that it could be used in anything from shop items, t-shirts, sweaters, and many other things I would not like to mention. Okay, seems like we're finished with the picture, so whenever you're ready, Sam. Oh, and by the way, our driver is Misael, one of our best drivers in the company. Airport used to be, but after Las Vegas grew so much, we extended our airport, and now this is just where private jets and helicopters land. The Tropicana, they have the Amav Museum that if you want to check it out, I suggest it. The MGM Grand was built in 1993 and has been one of the most successful properties. When it was first made, it was the world's biggest. have one bad document, they're going into a place to gamble. So they the whole entrance. And if you still hold a Wizard of Oz exhibit inside. We also have the M&M's world, where you can create your own M&M's with your name, your wife's name, your girlfriend's name, and also the Coca-Cola store. Inside they have Coca-Colas from all over the world. And Outback Steakhouse, that's always a good steakhouse to stop by for dinner. The Hard Rock Cafe is one of the newest additions. If you go inside, you can get a... Well, you can also buy the meals from us. They just show your the ticket inside and you will get a pretty good meal for $15. And at night you can see hula girls and fire dancing inside. It's quite a performance and it's free. Las Vegas is called an island of Hawaii because we have huge populations of Hawaiians visiting and staying here. And across the street, if you want to see an Elvis sing, you can see it at Big Bill's for free. He is called Big Elvis. He's quite big. He used to be bigger. He used to weigh 900 pounds. But he's down to a mere shadow of himself to 445 pounds. But he is one of the best singers of Elvis music you can find here on the strip. Okay. gives off flames that will, you can feel the heat all the way to the other side of the street. Inside the garage, they also have an aquarium where you can get the dolphins for only $10. You can do that. Those were not in the original plans. They were added when the wind saw the flying saucer right across the street at the fashion show mall. And he thought it was such an atrocity that he didn't want his customers to see it. So he decided to build a mountain with trees right in front of the pool and the high view of his customers. And you feel like buying a few diamonds, you can buy Cartier diamonds inside. And if you feel like playing golf, you can get these homes for only $500. Across the street at the plateau, this is where the sand used to be. Circus. This is going to be our transfer point, so be ready to depart. Just go straight to the front with the guys in the bright yellow shirts or jackets are. Ask them for your next bus. They will guide you into it. It was a pleasure having you guys on board. Remember, we run from 10 till 6. So be aware of the times, and if you guys are going to catch a night tour from here, be here, I suggest 10 minutes before 6:30 to catch that bus to take you to the night tour.
Here is the wind and the encore, and you guys can see a lot of the wind.
when I first heard that, I thought it was live, but I had a couple that worked there, so I asked to see a patient. And I did learn two things that day. I learned that that is his signature, and I also learned that she got paid for it. It's completely free to go inside. Right on your left hand side, you will see the fashion show off. The fashion show off. It's pretty unique because it has no casino tax on it. Also, there's runway shows on the weekends. Here at the fashion show off. And directly in front of us is the Donald Trump Tower. Donald Trump Tower actually has no casino. Therefore, Steve Wynn, being such an influential person, is actually got his own self-power block. So what Donald Trump did is come with a giant gold-plated tower. And sometimes when the sun rises, it will actually shine from the top of the tower into wind. Expensive drugs they have for you. Again, we're going to be right here on Industrial Road. Industrial Road is pretty much a street that the locals like to take to bypass the traffic on the Las Vegas Strip. The Las Vegas Strip is a very pretty sight. What the traffic is for.
Portland of Oregon State.
Oregon State?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Portland. Oh, okay. First time in Las Vegas?
Yes, right. First time.
Yeah. Enjoying it?
Yeah, I just arrived today in the morning.
Oh, today's the first day? Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Welcome to Las Vegas then.
Yeah.
Right here, again, it's like a Catholic church. And the thing about the Catholic church is because it's surrounded by casinos, they actually accept casino chips as offerings here at the Catholic church. And where are you guys from? We're in Canada.
Okay.
Welcome. Yeah, I have my other job, my supervisor is from Toronto. So, you guys are really, really nice. You're welcome. No, you guys are really nice. Magic, Canadians. Right here on your right hand side, you will see the indoor skydiving. Again, you get $10 off with your ticket for this. It's right behind the Walgreens. Right here. The next casino you'll see on your right hand side is the Riviera. The Riviera is actually a great film. The movie called Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas. And also they filmed most recently The Hangover. over right here in the Riviera. And you'll see some really famous statues on your right hand side. It's a crazy girl's no ifs and or buts statue. It'd be all bronze, except the bottom areas are very shiny. We have a lot of volunteers that can polish those areas for us. Everything inside of them made enough money to pay off the mortgage. So hopefully they'll reopen it or retail continue here. Right here on your left hand side, this is the world's largest gift shop. Right here. This whole corner here, you're looking here in Las Vegas souvenir. This is great right here at the Bonanza gift shop. And if we are lucky, we actually will get to meet somebody jumping off the tallest observation deck west of the Mississippi, the Stratosphere Hotel and Casino. If you guys look right on top, on your left hand side, you'll see a blue plank. People actually jump off that blue plank and land on that red deck right there. It's about $110 to do so. But it does include a DVD, that way you can see how you cried all the way down to show your family. Again, this is one legendary soccer player, Pelé, from Brazil, governor. There's a couple weddings going on right now. Over 600 weddings a day here in Las Vegas. On days like this Friday coming up, 11-11-11, they're expecting about 1,500 weddings. Actually, if you guys look to your left right after the street light, you will see the Welcome to Fabulous Downtown Las Vegas. If you guys were on the red route, you guys saw the Welcome to Las Vegas sign. Our miniature Welcome to Fabulous Downtown Las Vegas. Sign company right here on your left hand side. So welcome to downtown Las Vegas. Thank you, sir. And then coming up on your right hand side is a little white chapel. The little white chapel is made famous by Michael Jordan. This is where his wife. And right across the street is where they also filmed part of the movie The Hangover. Right here at the Little White Chapel, you get married drive-through, either in your own car or Elvis's pink Cadillac. There's all types of themed weddings here in Las Vegas. You get married by Elvis, who's the most popular. Married by Frank Sinatra, by knights, by monsters, by Star Trek characters, by Michael Jackson. Pretty much whatever kind of themed wedding you could think of. So you'll find this chapel that can help you to get to your Las Vegas. Coming up right after this next street light on your left hand side, when you get closer you actually get to see it, you'll see a very little Mexican restaurant called Doña Maria Tamales Mexican Restaurant. This is actually one of the best Mexican food here in Las Vegas. It was based on Las Vegas lawyers. And the law firm that it was actually based on was coming up right here on your right hand side. Okay, this is going to be your stop. I would like to remind you that to keep your tickets at all times, and your tickets will come back on the bus. And then hopefully you have enjoyed your tour. And bus timing every half hour, just to get up. And have a nice day. Be out there.
We just walked for like 6 hours and seen not one deer. And when we left, there was like a whole family of deer that just passed through the street. We were like, oh no. and like that wasn't part of the hunting area. So we couldn't hunt them. And we had to stop for like half an hour.
I've got a friend back home hunting partridge, not deer, but partridge.
Uh-huh.
No partridge.
Yes.
Grouse,
uh-huh.
Birds. And they got nothing during the day, and they were driving along the road, and they saw a partridge in the ditch. So a buddy stopped the car by. This guy grabbed his buggy and shotgun.
Is that where you want to, what do you want to see?
I don't know, what's, is there?
Because the best place for like the Fremont experience
is
the Golden Nugget. That is right here is the entrance.
Street. Is that the main street of
Las
Vegas?
This is Fremont. Well, there's Las Vegas Boulevard.
Yeah,
pretty much. Right here at the Golden Nugget, they have the world's largest gold nugget.
Really?
This plate, yes. Okay. It weighs 61 pounds, 11 ounces. Yes, it's huge. You can go see it. They also have one of the only two gold ATMs in the world.
Gold ATM?
Yes, where you can purchase gold by the ounce or by the gram. Really good shark tank.
Shark tank?
Yes. Huh. It's right next to the pool.
Yeah.
So right when you are going through the, like, there's a slide on it actually. And you go through the slide and you go through the shark. The shark is all glass and you see the sharks all around.
And you're going down a slide.
You're going down a slide looking at all the sharks around.
Okay, so where's that? Is that the...
That is all the Golden Nugget. Minions is where they have the $1 million picture and really cheap beer and margarita cocktails and a foot long hot dog for $2.
And then Minions.
Minions is a $20 picture. You put it up here to turn it up. And the drinks are at the Fremont.
At the Fremont.
Yes. I'll meet you downstairs. Look to your right hand side, you'll see Main Street Station Casino. It's actually a really good buffet. It's actually a very, very reasonable price. And they also have a lot of the old, like, antique slot machines right there on display. And one of the bathrooms from the guys, they actually have part of the Berlin Wall there. It's right on the urinal area, so you're kind of like European on the Berlin Wall. So it's really cool. I just think it's a guy's bathroom. I haven't seen the girl's restroom. I haven't gone in there. I haven't gone to the ladies' restroom, so I don't know. Right here on your right-hand side, behind this bus stop, is the Smith's Art Center. That tower right there. The building with the tower. It's actually going to be open
early next year. They actually have a theater inside, and Mary Poppins is actually going to be here for a couple weeks in March. Huh? Oh, the whole show, the Disney show is Mary Poppins. I just heard. This is where you'll get your business licenses, your fictitious names. There's county hall meetings there. And when I was little, I first arrived to Las Vegas when I was 5 years old. And when I first saw, and I used to call this little pyramid right here on your left hand side, called the Little Luxor. And actually, growing up in Las Vegas really changes the way you see the world. The first time I saw pyramids in Egypt was the top brands and outlet and factory prices. Actually, we have this red light right here. If you guys look to your left, this bus stop, they show pictures of how they build the bridge over the Hoover Dam. Yeah, this is what the pictures of how they're connecting to them. You guys drove from Canada?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Wow, that's a long drive. How long did it take? Zappos, the shoe company. This is our new city hall right here on your left hand side.